Phil Taylor up against Kevin McDyan, the surprise package of this tournament. Helen caught up with him on his day off.
Kevin, every couple of years, a new young player comes along that we all get really excited about, think can go on and do fantastic things. Is that you?
Yes, I think it can be me. Got to keep myself right, though. Healthy diet, not. But practice a lot and keep me focused on the game, to be fair.
You've only been pro for just over a year now. I think it was April last year that you turned pro. But how long have people been saying to you, you're as good as, you know, in a couple of years you can win this, you can win that, you can win the other?
Well, a lot of people up Newcastle says you can be the boy. Since I was, 12, I says. A lot of players had faith in us, so I kept my game right then as well. Obviously, I had a bit of cockiness in us when I was a kid. Had a bad attitude, but I've grew out of that and I just focus on what I've got to do.
OK, well, you've played twice already. In your first game, a couple of days ago, you beat Adrian Lewis 10-8. What do you remember about that?
Not a lot, to be fair. I also remember hitting a 1-2-1 checkout for a 12-darter. And I think I broke them back when I went 5-4 up, I think.
And then you played Mark Walsh, and that was 13-9. Now, you got a good command in that game, but Walsh, you didn't give up, did he?
Yeah, I went 4-1 up during the first break. And then I realised I was something like, 11-9, I think it was at one point, and I went, oh, what am I doing? I threw this away. But I put two legs together and it wanted to seal us the match.
So, I mean, obviously you knew that you were on the same side of the draw as Taylor. Do you have any pre-thoughts? Do you think, well, if I get through here and if I get through there, then when I get to Taylor, I intend to do this?
When I get to Taylor, I says, unlucky for him. No.
No. I thought you said all that cocky arrogance had gone.
It has, but I'm just looking forward to the game, to be fair. I take every game as it comes. I was happy to get through Adrian Lewis, it was a brilliant game. And then Mark Walsh was hard, it was a hard game for us. And I was really over the moon to get through that.
Come on, will you be honest with us if we say, if I say, how are you going to get on? Will you say, well, I hope to keep it respectable? Or will you say, no, I think I can beat him and mean it?
I think I can beat him, yeah. I've got the game to beat him. It's just mental side now and then goes a bit putty, but I think I can beat him, yeah.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to the action. We're live in Blackpool. The quarterfinal stage is off the Stan James World Match Play. Time to meet our players. Would you please welcome the pride of the North East? It's Super Mac, Kevin McDyan. We'll be right back.
Neil James Wade in one semi-final. These two battling it out for the right to face Dennis Priestley in the other semi-final. He's won this title 8 times. Can he make it 9 this week? Your commentators, John Gwynne and Stuart Pike.
Well, follow that. Wow, wow and wow again. Mardle beating Barney from 12-7 down. I'll tell you what, if Kevin McDine upsets Phil Taylor here, it would be one of the biggest upsets in the history of this great sport. The Winter Gardens still buzzing from 2 hours of magical entertainment. Now, the floor is Mr. Taylor's and Mr. McDine's.
Yes, that's right, 8 times the champion here in Blackpool, so this is the 15th staging. He has been beaten on a number of occasions. We can remember some. Is Kevin McDine going to add his name to the long list? Oh, the longish list of those who've managed to take out Taylor in the past. We'll see. Bob Anderson, the first back in 1994, Stuart, in a second round game. We remember Peter Everson a couple of years later. Well, if 2008 is going to be like 1994, 2006, on the other occasions when Taylor hasn't won this competition, it's this man who's got the chance now. 23 years of age, a Geordie, but living in Earthlingborough, Northamptonshire. And another 44. Of the crop of young players bursting their way through in this wonderful sport.
Well, there's no doubt the biggest 100. Night of Kevin McDine's darting career. He'll be nervous, the adrenaline will be pumping. I'm sure his hand will be shaking early doors as well. To play Phil Taylor in front of 2,000 people in the quarterfinals of the second biggest tournament in the world. Who'd have thought it?
Well, he's a confident young man. He might well have predicted it before the competition. That's what you've got to have, bags of confidence. Back it up with plenty of hits like that. And who knows? Oh, is this going to be our first maximum? Very close. Good effort, McDine.
Yeah, the one thing about Kevin McDine, he doesn't lack in confidence, doesn't lack in self-belief. He's got to the semi-finals of the Grand Slam, but Phil Taylor is a different proposition. All together. Haven't taken him long, has it?
No, as if to say to Kevin McDine upon hitting 140, here you are, son, this is what you can look forward to. Anything you can do, I will better it. Taylor, perhaps for an early break, may well finish this here. Can't now, but McDine can't finish, as you can see.
Oh,
180 from Taylor, followed by 40. Figure that one out.
Who you require 90 yards.
To break the throw in the opening leg.
Looking for treble 20, double 19, going down the bottom of the board, the green bit there. Now then, just above it, stack over the top, as Sid would say. Well, he didn't, did he?
He
went too high, so what a chance here for the 23-year-old.
And this would settle the nerves, that's for sure. He's going to get one dart at it. Well, there we go.
It's a pity, really, he didn't stay up there and go for double 18. Easy for me to say afterwards, but...
nerves, John.
Yes, I think you're right. However, Taylor... to split 19, wants double 8. Yes, first leg to the power!